Okay, a short installation video for all the Oxystar customers. Yeah. See, once you receive the package, open it carefully. We have already modified and kept the transformer for you. As all of you might be aware, this machine was actually designed for US and Mexican market. So you have to always use this only with this step down transformer. You need not purchase anything separately. We have included everything in the package for you. Okay, so this is a user manual, keep it aside. One nebulizer kit, one nasal prongs which is going to be connected to the patient for oxygen, and now the step down transformer. Always remember, without this you should not connect this equipment. Okay, keep that aside. Now he's taking the main unit. Lift it carefully. See how he's holding on both the sides. Take it carefully and keep it aside. Okay, so these are the full contents that you'll be getting in the carton box. Now see, he's going to connect this to our normal electrical supply, main supply, to a standard 5 amps plug. Okay, and then he is going to connect the machine cable to this transformer. Again we repeat, don't do the mistake thinking that you can put this directly to a travel adapter, the machine will instantly fail. This machine will require 110 volts. So the duty of the transformer is to step down the 220 volts to 110. So he has connected everything now properly. Okay, now let's see how he's going to switch it on. After giving the power supply on, switch on the transformer, you'll see the red color light. Okay, now see, the entire equipment is touch screen, so be very careful. Even small touches, either you'll switch on or switch off the equipment. You can see the power on and off switch here. Now let me switch on from the beginning often. Okay, so see, off position, just click this and the machine will boot up. Okay, so it's the touch screen is very sensitive. All you need to, if you want to get the oxygenation, press this button, oxygen. So instantly you can see the machine has started to boot up, and this is the flow meter. You can see the ball rising up. So set in whatever level the doctor has prescribed for you, whether if you want in 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a medical grade concentrator, so between 1 to 5, whatever flow rate you're going to keep, machine will go to 93%, and this will show you the digital oxygen concentration. Wait for at least 5 minutes to come to the maximum value. Okay, so now the oxygenation has started, and without water adding we have started the oxygenation. So dry oxygen is going to come out. Now here also, now you can add the cannula and start using it, but most of you will be using with the water inside the humidifier. I'll teach you how to remove and add the humidifier also. So just like adding normal water only, don't add saline water. No salt content should be there. Add purified or distilled water. So you can see the minimum and maximum marking here. Just make it in between these two. After that, screw the top properly. And see how he's inserting it. It has to be inserted in this position only. Okay. And you have to press it firmly. Automatically you will see the bubbles in the humidifier. And then you can connect the cannula. And see, after some few seconds, it has come to 95 and the flow rate is at 4. You can even take it up to 5 also. Up to 5, whatever flow you are going to keep, the concentration will be the same. We will also test it with the analyzer. Okay, now he has taken an industrial oxygen analyzer. Let us check the output. So you can see, even at 5 flow rate, the machine is giving you 94.4. that gets rounded off and shown as 95. So you can use it very comfortably. It will be very much useful for all the situations at home. Okay, now I'll teach you about the other functions also. Whenever you want to stop the oxygenation, just click this once, that's all. Automatically the compressor will stop and the machine will come to a rest state. Now coming on to the nebulizer option, nebulizer port is given here, you can see this one. Remove this carefully. After that, if you want to start nebulizer, just press this. You'll see nebulization starting to come here. Yes, that's all. Now you can add the nebulizer port here and you can start to use the nebulization. Same way, when you want to switch it off, just
click the buttons once again. That's it. Third one is for the timer. Generally, most of you will not use the timer. In case if you want to keep the timer, you can set it for like 1 hour or 2 hour, whatever you want. After that, the machine will automatically get switched off. So now we have completely taught you about how to use the equipment. Now just check this compartment. So here you can see there's a HEPA filter. Already our guys, while dispatching the product, they have done the necessary and kept the HEPA filter in the correct position. In case during transit, if this has come out also, we'll teach you how to properly reinsert it again. See the HEPA filter, you can see the holes there. It has to be always lined to this position, okay? There will be some grooves at the bottom. So the HEPA filter should be always in this position, and you have to attach it properly. It will come pre-attached only. In case during transit, if it has come out also, make sure the HEPA filter is properly attached like this. Once it is done, that's it. Everything is good to go. There will be one more filter at the back side of the device. This you can take it like once in a week or something, clean it and dust it and put it back inside. So that's about the entire device. So finally, a short summary once again. As we are insisting and stressing to you again and again, this batch of machines, since it was airlifted for emergency, these are all 110 volts device which were mainly designed for the US and the Mexican market. So we have given you a step down transformer. So always you need to connect the step down transformer first and then connect the machine power supply to the step down transformer. Without this, you should not switch on the equipment. If you are going to do that by directly connecting the machine to the electrical supply, the machine will instantly not work and the warranty will cease. So always remember, step down transformer is the first, that is very, very important. Second, humidifier bottle should be carefully removed. It should be taken in the upright position, add water between the minimum and maximum marking, and again place it gently. Finally, attach the cannula to this part. Now another main issue, main problem, the touch screen is very, very sensitive. So even while you are doing the humidifier part, if any one finger also touches these buttons, the machine will either switch on or switch off. So be very careful with this panel, it's ultra sensitive. And coming on to the flow rate, it's very simple. If you are going to rotate, it's going to increase or decrease, okay? And always keep the flow rate as per the advice of your doctor. Don't keep it according to your own wish. Some people think that keeping it 5 is the best. It's not like that. Each lung volume will be different. So depending upon the doctor's advice, if they advise 1 liter or 2 liter, keep it in 2 liters per minute and start using it. If you rotate it anti-clockwise, it's going to increase. Rotating it clockwise will decrease the flow rate, okay? And that sound, once in every 8 seconds, is a flushing sound. It indicates that the machine is working properly.